archaeologists have found that when they've gone to quarry sites, the track marks from the horses are deeper when they're coming out on the left hand side, because their carts are loaded, so they've got deeper tracks than those coming in. So they figured out that they drove on the left, but also documented that soldiers would march on the left as well. And that's a tradition then which stayed from the Roman era throughout the Middle Ages. Then it became important for knights and the jousting and people just generally travelling. They wanted to be able to defend themselves better should they need to against a robber or such like. And that would be easier because most people are right-handed. It will be easier if the opponent comes along on the right-hand side opposite to them, and then they could defend themselves more easily and also get off their horse and not have their scalping process. So that tradition kept it through the Middle Ages, and it was only later Napoleon wanted to march his armies in France. He wanted to march them in quickly, and so he marched in on the right-hand side and simply get out of the way for him. And then he introduced right-hand traffic then after the revolutionary period in France. It was often the case that many of the aristocrats used to travel on the left, but then everybody was made to travel on the right then. And later in the 20th century then the countries which remained driving on the left, they were essentially made to drive on the left, drive on the right. They were beginning part of they were conquered by Germany, so Austria, Hungary, many of those places were places which used to drive on the left, some of the constituent states there. Likewise, Portugal made the switch, and Sweden made the switch from the left to the right, and Italy as well, so Rome, where the Romans are used to stay on the left hand side, they all made the switch in the 20th century. And it was only Britain then and a few other countries, mostly former colonies, who stayed on the left hand side. That tradition has now been retained and unlikely to change now with all of the road construction and signage and such like that's taken up, which has been carried out ever since. That's unlikely to change at all. But incidentally then, when the British went to the States and built the colonies there, then they probably drove on the left, but then after the Revolutionary War 1776, there was a lot of movement then to move to the right-hand side as well, and to go to the other side of what the British do. The Canadians further north, they stuck on the left actually for a much longer period, and that was only in the early 20th century when the provinces were made to switch then, province by province. Quebec, in fact, was always on the right-hand side, being from the French. Actually west to east, then they made the switch because of the Model T Ford, and that was made, and Henry the Ford said you can have the steering wheel on any side you like as long as it's on the left, and that consequently meant that it was better for them to drive on the right, as did stage coaches as well. They were all driven by oxen, and it was better then for the driver to be on the left of the oxen, and so that tradition then came. And Canada, and also province by province in the 20th century, they switched over to the right-hand side as well. Newfoundland in the east, being the last one to do that. So a tradition which nowadays seems quite unusual, but in fact it's one which is really kind of where everybody else changed and Britain stayed the same. left side there, just across. No, that's the Euro style. Previously mentioned train that goes